How does good data management add value to research?
One of the key issues when you plan or design any research project is to have a data management plan. Students usually forget it. They get so obsessed with methodology that they forget what they're supposed to do, how they're supposed to collect data, and how to record it and how to keep it. And one of the good things is when you apply for ethics, you have to think about it, which is quite helpful. But one of the things I always tell my students, which I think is helpful, is to think about what is your audit trail for your data management plan, how you are auditing that it actually works. Because like anything else in research, if something, or even in clinical practice, if you give an intervention, if you don't know that it works, you actually have done, you might have done more harm than good. So every data management you plan, you have to also plan how you're auditing that the data is collected as you think it is collected and the quality of data is good. And you will be surprised that sometimes that even the easiest data collection, if you don't have an audit trail behind it, you might end up with errors in it that could be devastating later in the project. So it's helpful to prevent it early on.
As a patient, I have two views on good data management. The first view is simply that good data management means keeping it safe, not giving it to people who shouldn't have it, not leaving it lying around on trains, because that's what the newspapers tell me happens to it. Or it's sold to insurance companies and goodness knows what else. So on the one hand, that's good data management, keeping it safe, keeping my anonymity preserved. But on the other hand, as a patient who's had some serious illnesses, including cancer, good data management is actually making sure it's curated in the right way to be shared with other researchers, especially for rare cancers or common cancers with a rare offshoot. The only way you find out about these illnesses, the only way we really know what treatments are actually going to work, is by sharing data across patients, across countries, and making sure it is comparable and free to everybody to use it for legitimate research purposes.
So, I mean, good data management is absolutely crucial. It's an ethical responsibility that researchers have to honour the data they've been provided with and put it to best use. It's also efficient, not just ethical. It minimises the wastage of money that's been invested in research. And not only is it ethical and efficient, it's obligatory.
Sharing your data is really, it's really important for transparency. So if you have your data there and it's available and it's in a usable format, then it means that other people can not just interrogate it and kind of look at your work more closely, but they can also build upon it. So they can incorporate it into their future research, or it can become part of a bigger project or a meta-analysis or anything like this. So it's really important to think about how are you going to share your data with other people and plan ahead for that.
Do you think data sharing helps to reduce waste and increase transparency of research?
Yeah, I guess this is another very obvious question, and the answer must be yes, because we produce tons of data which are basically just lost because no one gets to know about it. Some of that data is useless because we not always create data that is that was done gathered properly and so forth. But we have a lot of data which is extremely useful, which goes into our reports, into our papers. But it's usually not the original data; it's just means and so compound data. And so sharing the original data that is actually to which we write about would be extremely helpful for others to extract additional information, to answer questions that they might have which we didn't have, and so forth. Also to check on the quality of our work. So sharing data, I think, is another, in a way, no-brainer, but it's something that many researchers don't like to do.
Well, I'm a big fan of data sharing and reuse of data, because so much data is wasted and so much research is then wasted. And it's not just to reduce waste, we have to remember it will increase the knowledge creation. And I'm more and more interested in this knowledge creation story, because clinical trials are happening all over the world, and if you can combine those data, you get more efficient research, and you can, of course, that's automatically reducing waste at the same time.
So two areas where I've used data sharing, one is individual patient systematic reviews, where you're doing a review of all of the studies in one area. You can use the published data for that, but actually it's more effort, but you can get a lot more done if you use the original data. But that requires a standardization process, cleaning up process, so you've got common outcomes, etc. The second use of for data sharing is to ask secondary questions. So quite a lot of the research I've done has taken existing databases but asked new questions of those databases. Sometimes it's been trials that I've been involved in personally, sometimes it's getting data sets from other people to do that. But it means it's much easier to do that than to spend the hundreds of thousands, if not sometimes millions of dollars or pounds in getting an original data set that would have answered exactly the same question.
So what data sharing can achieve is the ability to answer a research question with the available data when you don't need to go and gather any more to actually answer the question. So, for example, a systematic review and individual patient data meta-analysis of all the available data may successfully answer a research question without needing to get another research grant to go and collect more data.
And does it help transparency then?
So, what do you mean by does it help transparency?
Well, does it increase the transparency? Does it increase the transparency of research? This sharing of data.
Well, I think so. When you share data, you are exposing yourself to the need for external validation by another group of researchers. So they should always seek to confirm that your data show what you said they showed when you published them initially. So I think you subject yourself to scrutiny. And I think making it an expectation of researchers also means that they are very careful in the way they collect and document their research in the first place, knowing that data sharing is one day ahead of them.